to the Bali's Fitness Expo. It's really exciting here, lots of things happening, and of course you're all here to see the Shaomori Monks, maybe in a few minutes. I'm Graham Slater, Chairman of the International Martial Arts Alliance, and we've got a stand over here in D51. I'd like to thank the Bali's Fitness Expo, AC Media, about helping us with this Shaomori Monks. Martial arts has fascinated people for many years, with speed, power, finesse, philosophy, and so much more. It's great to see the first opportunity to have the Shaomori Monks teaching in Australia, and this is a mini troupe that's come out from China. So there's 3 members. They're normally in a big group of 50, they have plenty of time to rest, so they'll be going. I'll be here to help if you have any questions you'd like to ask. You can ask them directly to the monks. So hopefully we should be able to demystify some of the myths about the Shaolin Temple. Without further ado, let's welcome the Shaolin Warrior Monks. Give a warm round of applause, please. Woo! Here you go! See you next year. Yes, they will be back. They will be back. The Shaolin Temple, I was fortunate to visit there last year, and it's awesome valleys and mountains and so forth. You get a bit of an understanding of how they really practice and talk. I'm going to introduce you to basically different styles in there. In the Shaolin Temple, they practice all different types of martial arts. They do about 18 weapons, and these guys here, Shaolin Temple, there's a lot of work for the people who are poor and underprivileged children, orphans and so forth, and really help them along. So they're able to enter the Shaolin Temple at a very early age. Now you will see that the monks are quite young. The eldest is 26, the youngest is 21. And I'll tell you a little bit more about those shortly. So let's introduce, I think it's... Ah, oh, it's Feng Yin, Master Feng Yin. Okay, please welcome Master Feng Yin. Here we go.
Yeah.
any one of those teams. And you'll see they use, we haven't got many weapons today. And first of all, in the early show on Saturday, we had these along a stick, so forth, but that's shattered in the first set with so much power behind those sticks. But fortunately, we're not hitting anything with some of the sticks. Now I'd like to next introduce you to Master Poe. Those swords are not too much sharp, but very thin, so they've got that cutting blade. When I was in China, I was talking earlier, that one of the guys in the cage fight competition, and I'll tell you a little bit about that in a minute, you're moving that sword so fast, and because of all the power, it flexes so much and slaps his throat. So you've got to be very careful. It takes a lot of skill, a lot of years of training to get that just right, and you know, to crank it safely. When I was there, I was fortunate enough to stay in the Shaolin Temple, just outside in the hotel. All into the grounds, the great valleys and so forth. The whole area of Henan Province is covered with martial arts people. And just to give you a bit of an idea of how many people are involved in the martial arts over there. These guys are from the elite guard. So there's 50 people in the top part of the elite guard of the Shaolin Temple. Next tier down is 200. And next tier down there is 20,000. Those 20,000 in the grounds all practicing martial arts. And I remember waking up, the whole place was shaking at 5 a.m. in the morning, going, gee, what's that noise? I go outside, look at the windows, all these just rows and rows of people, all in this little track suits, running. The whole place is shaking. There's like 20,000 of them all running around, all practicing. And they start at 5 a.m. in the morning, practicing 6-7 hours a day, as well as other studies and so forth. And then in the township of Denfang, there's a further 60,000, lots of martial arts schools. So those interested in martial arts, it's a good place to go. Shaolin Temple, thought of as being the origin of martial arts. All the martial arts have come from. So really fascinating. Those traditions will continue on as the martial arts practice again. Please welcome Master Piao. Working out the routine, keep changing on me all the time. So they're very energized, okay? So I'm just going to introduce Master Feng Yin, who's going to do the stick routine. And we've also seen Jackie Chan do the drunken pole, and here's Fun Ying's Drunken Pole. Please welcome Fun Ying. What are you drinking? Yeah, just be relaxed, mate. We've got a couple more sets. Next is Master Poe. We'll do an unarmed technique. He's going to fly out. And then, but before we do that, I'm going to tell you a little bit about K-Star. K-Star is a film audition. It's a reality show where you get the opportunity to become a movie star. It sounds pretty good, doesn't it? Last year, 300 million people saw the show in China alone, let alone the other countries. What it was, the search for the next Jackie Chan, Jet Li. And that was last year. But the guy you just saw there, Fung Yin, was trained in the Shaolin Temple, but his real forte is in performing. He came 10th in the world in the competition. So that's why we selected him from China to come out here and just show his stuff. He's got some phenomenal stuff, as well as, of course, the Shaolin monks. But the K-Star now this year is open to all female artists. So if you're a personal trainer, dancer, coordinator, singer, actor, martial artist, any of that, you get an opportunity to audition. And you can send in a DVD showreel with some photos and do it by post. We're selecting people there. You can actually audition here. We start the auditions right here at Filex. And we're doing all through the year until September. So you need to get all the auditions in by the end of August. And then we're sending three lucky winners, females, to China for 1 month. To train with these guys, the Shaolin Warrior Monks. Also do stage performances and compete with 10 other countries. For the coveted movie deals. So there'll be about 10 movie contracts given away. So you go off the competition stand, run into your first movie or your second movie or whatever. So next up, we've got Master Piao. But before we go, remember, at D51 Martial Arts Australia and IMA, you can audition there and get some information. And also after the show, we've got t-shirts to give away and you can have a chat with the Shaolin Warrior Monks and they can autograph anything for you. Okay, now please welcome Master Poe.
Oh,
more energy than I'm having today. Hope you're all having a great day at the Fitness Expo. Let's welcome Master Piao. Okay, you've got a great opportunity. We've still more to come. But we've got an opportunity now just to have a... Maybe we've got three questions. If you'd like, anybody would like to ask, three people can ask a question, and the Royal Monks would certainly like to answer. Or if I can answer it, I'll answer it. But of course, you'd like to hear from those guys. And after that, we're going to finish with a battle scene for the open hand and weapons. Please welcome the guys on board again, please. Now, especially your kids is really good. I think I answered the question, it's a bit easier. Ask the kids. So, does anybody have a question, please? I'd like to know something a little bit more about the Shaolin monks? Yeah, okay. Okay, yeah, I'll give you the names. I think I remember that. That's good. This is Master Feng Yin, Master Po, Master Piao. And this guy, 21, 22, and 26. So he started very young. And if you want to know how long I've been training, it's about 15 years, 11 and 10. So it depends what you can do when you put your mind to it and train really hard. Any more questions? That was an easy one, thanks for that. Okay, over here. But that's a hard one. How are they selected in to go into the temple? Fortunate enough to have a contact in the Shaolin Temple. The Shaolin monks do teach a number of foreign people so that you can make a journey over to the Shaolin Temple and actually train these guys if it's possible. About living in the temple, that's a different kettle of fish. But our last question, please. Any more questions? He's a bit shy, that's okay. That's good. Anybody have any questions? Only two this time, only two. The question was, is there any women, women monks, do they practice martial arts as well? That was the question. I haven't seen any over there, but we'll ask that question.
Yes, There is actually a temple which is under the Shaolin Temple, and they accept women, female monks, and they study the martial arts there as well.
Well, thanks, pretty awesome. I'm glad you answered that question. I've been educated as well. That's great. There is an opportunity this time, if you're entering into the K-style competition, you will be trained by them, the elite warrior monks as well. So that's part of the deal. So if you've got any ideas that you're looking into film, television, that's very easy to audition. Okay, we're going to move back and we've got another bit more of the show for you. So sit back and enjoy, or stand. Okay, we'll see you on the next show. Okay. Hold on a second. part of our show is we invite people up on the stage for 5 Gregorian monks. So you're all happy to do that? Have we start off with the kids? No, the second one. Now we are at stand D51, so this is the end of our show today, and hope you've enjoyed it. We're over D51, Martial Arts Australia over there, and don't forget, if you're interested in the Taste Line competition, feel free to go over there. If you'd like, Jesse's going to come out here right now with the guys. If you'd like a photographed t-shirt with Piao and Po in there, feel free to go to our stand. We've got a limited number over there. If you'd like to talk to the monks, get an autograph on, go to D51, it's $25. I think they got there now, that's great. Please thank the Shanagori monks, please. Thank you.